A survey carried out by German tech site Chip.de has revealed just how much people are willing to shell out for the upcoming PlayStation 5. Let's talk about that. If I was to ask you guys the question, what would be the maximum price you'd be willing to pay for the PlayStation 5? What would your response be? Well, like I said in the intro, a survey was carried out by a German tech site, Chip.e, which is well known, and it has revealed just how much people are willing to shell out for the upcoming PS5. If you look at it, it's a hotly debated topic, and analysts have been competing with one another to predict just how much the PlayStation 5 is going to be. I've heard numbers as low as $300 and all the way up to $1,000 US. A recent PS5 price placeholder from a Swedish retailer, we talked about this on the Saltiest Gaming Podcast, shameless plug, made the news because it implied it would cost 9,999 krona. That is their currency, not the US. In US, it'd be around $1,000 for the device. So, Chip.de gave people the opportunity to state what would be their maximum willing price to cough up for a PlayStation 5, and the results are pretty interesting. Honestly, it's right around what I thought people would be willing to pay for the PlayStation, because let's be honest, there's a lot of people out there that said, hey, look at the PlayStation 3 that came out at $600. People were telling you to get a second job to pay for the PlayStation 3, and look how that went. But how many years ago was that? Way over 10 years ago. I mean, this is a different day and age. The medium household income is different. There's all kinds of stuff that goes into how much a consumer is willing to pay for technology. If they deem it is worth the price, they're pretty much willing to pay whatever. But that being said, there was 6,000 participants in this study, and 600 euro was apparently the magic number. That's the figure that was said the most. 600 euros comes out to be around 700 bucks is the most people would be willing to pay for the PlayStation 5. And if you look at that, based off the technology that they're putting into the box, a good CPU, great GPU, taking the results of the survey into account, if Sony places its price below 600, then it should encourage healthy sales. But if they start to exceed that maximum spending limit of $700, that's where there's a sharp decline that's visible in the survey's graph. So from 600 to 700 euro, which max US 700 bucks, there's a sharp decrease in the amount of people that are willing to pay that price. So it wouldn't be a smart decision for Sony executives to come out and say, hey, we're pricing the PlayStation 5 at $750 US. It's important, like I said, to put into consideration that there's going to be a custom Ryzen and Navi components from AMD. There's going to be super fast SSD drive in there. You got to take all these things in consideration when you're putting a price tag on the PlayStation 5. I personally said that I believe it's going to be $500 US, but as we said again on the Saltiest Gaming Podcast, Trump has confirmed that he's going to be putting tariffs on technology made in China, and this is going to be a 10% tariff. Now, if you do the math and the console is supposed to be $500, add an extra $50 on there, it's still within this maximum spending limit for consumers, according to the survey. It's not a huge survey, and it was done in Germany, so you could take it with a grain of salt, but I'm an analytics guy. I like to look at numbers, and I think you could take things from this, and you can kind of analyze it and put it into what you would see in the future for a price point for this console. And that's why I like to do these videos, because I like talking to you guys and picking your brain and seeing what you guys think. What is your max spending limit for a next-gen console? Is it $700 like the study said? Is it $600? Because the graph on here, which I'll show right now, it's the 600, it's like a bell curve, right? So you have 100 on the way polar opposite, which it's not going to be, and then 1,000, which it's not going to be, right? And then 600's that sweet spot. So I think that a $550 console, $500 console, depending on the tariffs, I think it will do very well in the market. Now, if they exceed that, I think that's when you're going to start cutting out a lot of the casual market. So if you look at it from state household net adjusted disposable incomes in the United States and Germany, The U.S. is about 45,000 to 34,000 respectively, but gamers in Brazil are about U.S. 12,000 and South Africa about 11,000. So these type of countries are less likely to be willing to pay as much for these next-gen systems, so that's where you would see a sharp decline in the consumers that buy this, and generally the people that are out there day one buying the technology are the people that are the hardcore, like you and I, right? We're out there standing in the rain like I was for my systems at Best Buy day one with all the other crazy people out there, and we're getting our systems. We pre-order them and we get them no matter what. But when you're looking at the casual market, it's a different story. So I thought this was an awesome article. I will put it in the description for you guys to check it out as well. Let me know what you guys think is an acceptable price point for you guys. What is the max that you're willing to pay? I want to talk about it in the comment section down below. This is why I do my channel. I love talking to you guys. Just to let you guys know, if you guys haven't figured it out already, the Saltiest Gaming Podcast happens every Thursday, 9 p.m. Eastern. I'd love to see you guys in the live chat. Hopefully, I'll see you. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, hit the like button, subscribe, hit the bell icon for future notifications. I hope you guys have a great day. And as always, stay salty, my friends.